Jenny, and I'm going to show you how to remove shoulder pads from a vintage blazer. This is a vintage Jones wear, super cute blazer from the 90s that I got at a Goodwill store. And you can make it into a blazer that you can actually wear to work with jeans, that is similar to something that costs a lot of money now. So the way that you do that, you turn it inside out, and on the inside of the shoulder there's seams, so you find the thread in the seam. And you take, this is called a seam ripper. You can get these at Hobby Lobby or at Joann's Fabric or Amazon. So you find the thread and you put the seam ripper under the thread. And you just do this until you have a hole in there. Made a hole in the seam here. And there's a tack, the seam is actually tacked to the shoulder. So you'll have to cut that, this tacking piece right here. You'll have to cut that as well to get it to come up off of the shoulder pad. But then you find the edge of the shoulder pad by just kind of feeling around in there. And you do the same thing. So here's the shoulder pad, and you can kind of pull it through the hole. Accidentally ripped it. But after you do this, then you sew the hole back up with black thread, or with the thread the color of the lining of the blazer. But here's where the shoulder pad start sewing. You can find usually they're sewn in pretty loose, so it's easy to cut the thread that's sewing it. But you just have to make sure you don't cut the actual blazer. So I'm getting it out now. So the shoulder pad's out now, and now you can see the shoulder. Now sometimes if you do this, the shoulder is going to be too long for your shoulders. So in another video, I'll show you how to shorten the shoulder and to make it fit your shoulders better. But this one is going to fit fine because it's a really cute petite blazer. I'll show it to you in a minute. On with an outfit, but so on the inside of the sleeve now, what you have is a rip in the lining. Now the blazer part is still, it hasn't been touched or anything, so you just have to take some black thread and a needle and sew up the lining, and I'll show you how to do that. So I have a needle and thread here with black thread on it, and you pinch the lining of the blazer and go in, do a stitch in and out along the line, along the seam, to close it up. And this part of the lining does not get a lot of stress, so just a simple stitch will be good to close the seam back up. And then do that until the end of the rip, and that will fix it. Also, don't forget to tie a knot at the end of the stitch. So the way you do that is you make a loop with the thread. And then you put the needle through the loop and make it into a knot. And then pull it tight, and that closes it off so it won't come back undone.
Here's the jacket with the shoulder pads removed, and I'm wearing a Casper stretch satin shell, a vintage 80s Avon necklace, which as you get older, your necklaces have to kind of get lower. If you're, you know, in your 20s, you can wear shorter necklaces, look better on younger women. But my earrings are teardrop pearls, and my pants are Anne Klein cropped fitted pants, and my shoes are a 3-inch brown Mutitsis, and because my outfit was affordable, I have a Dooney for my computer.